Hello everyone, how are you? I'm Luciana, this is my YouTube channel 24 Horses Per Second, and today I'm gonna show you how to blur the ends of an image or video in compositing in Blender. I use this technique for this 3D render, so let's begin. First, we need to go to the compositing tab in Blender and enable use nodes. Gonna delete this and let's add an image node. Connect the image with image and let's add a viewer node. Just click in the image node and Ctrl Shift. Open. In my case, I'm gonna choose all these files because it's an image sequence, but you could also choose a single image or video format. The image in the background is pretty annoying if you ask me, so let's disable that and let's open it in a new window. Here you can choose the image editor or the UV editor, and let's open our viewer node so we can preview the effect. Remember to match the frames of your animation for the export. And the frames per second. And the resolution as well. And make sure your viewer node is in the image output. If you keep pressing Ctrl Shift, it changes the output. For the masking, we do need to go to the image editor, mask. New, rename, open this menu, match the frames of your animation, and click while pressing Ctrl to mask. A new mask layer will appear. And in the last point of the mask, right click, toggle cyclic. Now let's add a mask node. A blur node. An alpha over node. And a combined RGBA node. And let's connect. Let's choose our mask that I named Blur. Add. You could choose Smooth in here, Fast Gaussian, Relative, and let's change these values depending on the result you want. Now this background is not transparent, it's just black, So to get the alpha background, remember to choose a format that allows an alpha channel, like PNG. Here the RGBA means red, green, blue and alpha channel. Also enable use alpha, and in the combined node set the alpha value to 0. And here it is. Now you can render this. I rendered this as an animation, and then I used it on top of my cap footage to simulate the steam of the tea. This is actually part of my anime cap series where I'll teach how to make this render from scratch, so if you're interested, check it out. And that's it. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.